sorry for the delay, everyone. This is a Grand Celestial here with another walkthrough episode for the game Eureka 7 Volume 2, The New Vision. Alright, I'm on Chapter 6. If you're hearing the machine noise in the background, well, that's just me turning on the heater because it is cold in here. I'll just save my money.
You don't have any regrets? You know, about coming here and me.
You're determined to destroy the CFS lab, even if it costs you your life, right?
It's the one thing that's kept me going all this time.
That feeling was contagious. I'm just as prepared as you are. But Ruri, I'm not gonna let you die. I'll protect you, Ruri. With all the strength I have.
Sumner, I don't know what to say.
Don't get all soft on me. It's not like you, Ruri.
You're right. Thanks a lot.
Let's go put an end to this. Together.
I thought that was too easy.
Right?
Yeah. I bet that's the final boss I have to fight.
This light, this LFO, don't you find them beautiful? This LFO is to be commemorated as the first ever to be equipped with a CFS. The specs of this masterpiece are equal to those of any top-of-the-line LFO. This is my LFO.
Whoa, spooky.
I'm waiting for it.
Wait.
Come with me. Walk with me down the path to the new world. You'll be the very first. The first to walk it.
This is wrong. You're the one who taught me how to lift. No. I won't go anywhere with you. You're insane.
Say this is wrong.
A new world isn't something that you can create. We have to live. All together. In this world.
That's right. You chose to run away from this world. And you hope for a future that doesn't even exist. No. CFS rots the body and takes over the soul. You believed in it because that's what CFS wanted you to believe.
But all the while, you were losing your humanity because of your addiction to it.
The human. How is it that you can put such blind faith in a thing like that?
You just have to ask what the other person is feeling. That's all it takes. I've always believed in you, Sumner.
Ruri, I believe in you too.
Would you stop? Just hearing that slop makes my skin crawl.
Flame, it's all over. We've already planted explosives. If I press this, it's all over.
Press it. You'll die too.
I'm okay with that.
Well then, what are you waiting for? Go on and do it.
Ruri, I love you.
Thank you, Sumner. I love you too.
Thank you. not sure if I'm gonna get doing more working. If they're gonna have more character stages in this game. That's all I get?
Thank you.
you've made it through the game starts kicking your ass.
Careful!
I can't dodge all that! What the fuck? I still have plenty of life to spare.
If we make it through, we'll have a shot. Any more damage?
Thunder, watch out! This way!
I see you.
A little more!
Oh, finally. I feel like I could go on a bit longer. It's giving me one more chance to use the shot. Useful for high speed lifting camera. Requires two heavy missiles for the group. Not sure what I should go for. Go with the missile pod.
Is flame
after an explosion like that?
It's over, isn't it?
All that's left now is to escape. Zapter! Loki, you're alive! Of course I am! It's if I flame out in a place like that!
It's amazing that you two managed to survive this long, Jillian.
Heading this way. It'd be best if you two clear out. Let me take it from here.
And what about you guys?
We're heading over to headquarters for now.
Headquarters? But the situation's still too risky.
Wouldn't it be safer to wait for reinforcements?
There's someone else we have to take down before they get here.
Look, Flame died in the CFS lab. I Asher doesn't have a leader anymore.
Asher isn't the enemy.
But wasn't Flame the one in command of Thundercloud?
He was only the public face of Asher. He was there to be the symbol that got the kids to rise up and join their revolution.
Then, who led?
He easily took it over from the inside without ever alerting the military's ultra-tight security network. Why is that?
They had a mole inside the military.
Plus, the only kind of person that could carry out such a huge operation would be...
not just military, an officer.
That's right. We're going after...
I don't believe it.
Stephen Beeson.
It's true. He's the mastermind.
There's an elevator that goes to HQ at the end of this corridor. Okay, let's go.
Ha ha ha! Yeah, I took too much time in this episode, so until next time, see ya.